21 knots, right down the angle.
My name is Lieutenant Commander Kale Nichols. I'm a staff LSO with the Air Wing. LSO stands for Landing Signal Officer. Another name for that is CAG Paddles. I serve on board the USS Ronald Reagan, which is forward deployed to Yokosuka, Japan. And CVW-5 has been at Marine Corps Air Station Iwakuni for just over a year now. We finished fixed wing squadron move down there in 2018. So the Air Wing enjoys being there, and it's a great location to operate out of. And to me, CVW-5 is valuable in this part of the world to provide security and stability. When I think of CVW-5, we're kind of that air element, the air piece of solving that puzzle. So I think the impact in accomplishing that mission is the fact that, you know, we can be on station, you know, within a day's time, whenever the call comes, we're there, as opposed to a CONUS-based air wing or carrier. We can be here on station quite quickly. Yeah, keeping the aircraft airborne for CVW-5 is 24/7 missions. On flight ops, it takes dozens of people up on the flight deck. And probably just about the same standing watch stations below the flight deck. So all that comes together in one orchestra to launch and recover hundreds of aircraft on an aircraft carrier a day. I think an aviator should come to 7th Fleet for the value of the mission that we serve out here. So the forward presence that 7th Fleet, that FDNF provides to this AOR, very important to providing security and stability for the region. So being a part of that has a lot of personal reward with what you provide to that team. As an aviator, you'll get experiences, I think, that CONUS-based air wings and ships won't necessarily get. The traveling and visiting our partner nations out here is also a huge benefit. So I think all those combined are the primary reasons why I would recommend aviators coming out to 7th Fleet.